Hi friends, welcome to my channel. My name is Juan, I'm a yarn addict, hence the name Juan the Yarn Addict, and I want to thank each and every one of you guys for stopping by to check out my video today. This is a yarn and crochet channel where we talk about all things yarn and all things crochet. So if that interests you, please sit back and watch this video because today we're having coffee and cake. So my friends, I have a live tonight. It's April 14th, 2024. And at 6 p.m., I'm going to start my live like I always do. But this week in particular, I'm going to be giving away my scrap cakes. And the scrap cakes that I'm going to be giving away are the ones that I'm making in this video right here. So let me just move the coffee out of the way. And I'm going to show you my scrap bin. So it's an old laundry hamper that never was used as a laundry hamper. I bought it on clearance and converted it to what this is right now. It holds all of my scrap yarns and things. Now, some skeins are more used than others. The further down you get, the smaller the balls are. But nonetheless, I'm going to be using all the things for the cake. So we have muted colors with neons. I have variegated in here with whites. It's going to be a hodgepodge of all the things. And so what I'm going to do, I'm going to just talk to you about whatever comes to my mind while I, you know, cake up the yarns. But because I'm not keeping these cakes, I'm going to be using the magic knot on my joins just because I feel like, you know, not everyone likes the knots the way I like mine because I like the tails and I don't worry about sewing them in. I just, you know, it's a thing. But since these are not mine, I'm going to do everything correct. And so we're just going to go ahead and get started. I'm pulling something, anything, you know, no rhyme, no reason. But one thing that I do when I cake up is I create a slip knot with the yarn, just like that as a starting point. So when you grab your cake to start your work, you don't have to worry about creating the slip knot. It's already there. And if you don't want to use this for whatever, you can just pull on the tail and it'll go completely flat. So I'm going to put this on the ball winder like so, like this. Okay. And now with this metal piece here, I don't know if you can see it. You literally just wind it around like so, like that. Okay. You kind of want that effect. Yeah. So you just want the yarn to go through that hole there. Someone asked me about that. So yeah. All right. So as I wind, I'm going to talk, like I said, but there's no magic number here, okay? I'm literally just winding until I decide to change the color. Now, from experience, I know that I need to change often. So, you know, there's going to be a lot of cutting and tying and things. So, yeah, there's that. Oops. Okay. So first color's off already, and I'm going to grab a basket to keep those in because we're going to bounce back and forth and do all the things, okay? So I have this little itty-bitty ball. We're going to work that up. So to do a magic knot, I'm going to tie on this end just a simple knot. Like that, and then on this end I'm going to tie a knot like so, like that. One of the reasons why I don't do the magic knot, it's time consuming. You know, but it works, you know, it does work, it does the things, it does everything you want it to do and then more. So I'm just going to trim that down. I'm not going to take it all away because, you know, as you're working it, you can trim it for yourself if that's what you want. But this is what, this is the best that you're getting from Juan the Yarn Addict. Because I like the tails, okay? Okay, already we're changing. I'm telling you, these scrap cakes where it changes often, it's the best ones. I'm telling you, especially when you're doing like a corner to corner or a granny square. Actually, anything. You can go back and forth if you want. Like, you know, it doesn't matter. When it changes often, it's unexpected, it's a surprise, it's all the things. All right, so let's do something bright and poppy. All right, let's put some neon in here. So we're gonna like this because on the camera it's showing very nicely this orange. So it's good visuals, it's giving us what we need. Oh, I think I had too much coffee. It's okay. You know what I mean? We love a good cup of coffee 7 or 8 times a day. All right. So let me just go ahead and do that. Let me slip it in there. Okay, good. All right. So I'm just going to do a little snippet, just like that. Beautiful. Okay. Right. Yeah, a lot of scrap caking. I mean, unless you're just making a solid scrap cake situation, when you're making it like this, it is a little time consuming, but that's fine. We don't mind that at all now, do we? Let's go ahead and pick a variegated yarn to throw in there. We have this. Love that. I can't remember for the life of me where I got that. I'm thinking Michael's Loops and Threads. Yeah, I think that's what that is. Michael's Loops and Threads. I have a lot of that in this house, let me tell you. I love it. I think once I get used to doing this, the speed will just naturally come. Just, there we go. Nice and tight. Okay. I do a regular old knot, and that's it. Unless it's not for me, then I do all this. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Good. Okay. So we're just leaving them in there because we're going to bounce back to them. You know what we need? I think we need a good purple. Do I have a purple in here? Yes, I do. Okay. There's no thought process behind picking these colors. I'm literally like, okay, what color do I feel like throwing on here next? You know? And I think that's what makes these little scrap cakes as good as I think they are, you know? So I love that. Okay. So there we go. I've seen several tutorials on YouTube for this magic knot situation. It really is. It's very easy, you know? Sometimes I hype myself up for no reason, you know? Like, oh my goodness, it's gonna take so long, but not really. It really doesn't take that long. Good, good, good. Okay, and what else? Let's see. What color can we throw everything off with? Here we go. Love that for us. So it's black, white, and gray stripes. Oh, yeah. Love that. So I pick odd colors on purpose. I think it makes it so interesting, and it makes you wonder, like, wow. I never thought those colors would look that way together. So, yeah, just exploring the colors and having a ball doing it, you know. So that's fine. So there we go. Just pull that out like that. Come on, Juan, you can do this. Oof. There we go. Okay. So there we have that. All right. And yes, some of these I will leave run for a little while because we like that, you know, thick, thin, you know. The variation is, I guess, the word I'm looking for. Okay. There we go. Okay, so let's see. We have blue, blush, purple, variegated orange. Something tells me we need something to really pop. So let's go ahead and do some of this. some of this bright yellow. Okay. Now, just because of how long this actually takes, I'm probably not going to do all the scrap cakes on this video. I'll probably run out of time before that happens, but that's okay. I'll show you one or two at least. There we go. So, to my surprise, like, lots of people love scrap cakes. I honestly wasn't one for the scrap cakes a while back. I didn't really care for it. But then I realized, wait a minute, there's so many things you can do with scrap cakes. You know, and the more I learned, the more excited I got. I'm like, okay, now I see. I get it. So, yeah. We need something to really throw this off. Let's see. Here we go. Speckle yarn from Red Heart. Yes, we love that for us. Now, I thought about doing like themed scrap cakes. Like maybe pulling all of the neons together and doing like a scrap sequence of neons. I mean, I was literally thinking of all the things. And the one conclusion I came to was, let me figure this out first. There we go. Okay. I'm not going to know how good it looks until I try it. So I do plan on trying like themed scrap cakes because I do have a lot of scrap cakes. I mean, a lot of this leftover balls and things. I have tons of these from over the years. And so, yeah, I'm going to do some neons. I'm going to do some like earthy tones. But what I really like are these like oddballs. To me, this is where it's at. I just love this. All right, let me move this out of the way. Okay, let's trim that. And let's go back to the basket here. So let's go ahead and finish this up. It's a little ball here, piece of cake. We'll finish this off. Okay. So magic knot. I'll tell you, I can get through these cakes so much faster by using that. I call it a sloppy knot. I can, but also I understand that like not everybody crochets the same way or does things the same way. So yeah, I get it. And because I get it, I'm taking the extra time to do this. There we go. But the ones I make for me, sloppy knot all the way. Yep, sloppy knot all the way, my friends. Okay. Oops. I forgot to pull on the tension there. Okay, there we go. It's always good to keep tension. You know, when you're doing this. So, wasn't there, okay, here it is. We have another small one here, which is great for us. Okay, so let's go ahead and do this. And let's do this. There we go. Magic knot, here we come. Just tie it like this. I think it's like just one of those things, like once you get used to it, it's second nature, but when it's something that you're not accustomed to doing all the time, it's like, oh goodness gracious, here we go, you know. Anyway, my mom still sticks to her guns. She prefers this. But I said, Ma, how are you making scrap cakes or scrap balls? I mean, you're pulling these all together to just make another ball. I mean, she's like, yes, Juan, that's how we've always done it. I'm like, okay. I mean, she's not lying. I mean, I totally get it. You know, there weren't always ball winders. Okay. there is that. What else? What else? Let's go back to a neon color. Let's do that for us. Whoever gets this scrap cake is going to love it. Like, I'm in love with it now. I'm like, are you kidding me? All of these brights and darks and contrasting colors and things. Oh, it's so good. So good. Okay. So here is that. Okay. So I'm thinking for tonight's giveaway, 2 cakes per winner. And since I'm still giving like books and things away, for like Sophie's and things, we have a few Sophie's books that was gifted to us by viewers and things. So not all of today's winners will get scrap cakes. Let me start over here. I have to keep that tension just right. Okay. There we go. Okay. Next, next, next. No. Yes. Actually, do we want to do speckled or do we want to do variegated? Let's do variegated. Yeah, it's time for some of that in our life. So, yeah, I think once I cake these all up, I'm actually going to bag them as well. Like, you know, in clear bags and things, just so that it's like official and ready to go. At least, I mean, I think that's what makes sense in my mind. Hold on 1 second. It's really hard to take my eyes off of this. Okay, there we go. It's short enough. I don't have to trim it. Okay. Whoops. Wow. It fell off the table. Ugh. Okay, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. Okay. So as you see, I'm actually gaining more traction with, you know, the turns and all. Just because now that the cake is getting bigger, it's going to require more yarn. So let me just clear this so everything's not bouncing all over the place. Okay, there we go. All right, let's go ahead and get this on. One of these days, I'm gonna be super fast at this magic knot. I mean, I'm not bad, but I could be better. Okay. Let me, it's fine. Should I trim that? Yes, I should. In good conscience, I need to trim. Okay. Let me just hold the basket in place. Let's do this blush color because it's unexpected next to that bright yellow. Okay, okay, okay. Yeah, this is good. Okay, love this. Anyway, I hope everyone is having a fantastic Sunday or day if you're seeing this after Sunday. I mean, you don't have to watch it just on Sunday. Can you imagine? Okay, there we go. So, yeah, At least here in Delaware, the weather's super nice for once. I feel like it's always like raining or something as of late. But today we have a very, very good situation happening outside. So lots of fun for us out there. Love that. I caught some sun before doing the video, so that's nice. And before the live tonight, I plan on going outside and getting more sun, which is awesome. Hopefully this summer I'll be able to record outside, out back. Because I really do like being outside. And, you know. Okay, I just lost. Okay. Stay focused, Juan. Stay focused. Come on, come on, come on, come on. There we go. Okay. There we go. Let me put this down here. Okay. This might actually be better. Okay. It's okay if it makes that noise. It's not, I don't know. It's fine. There we go. Okay, okay, okay. What else can we throw in here? Let's put some of this in here. Yes, we love that. Right next to the purple too. How fitting. They just seem to flow together. What is the exact colorway of this? Let me read this. What is the exact name of this? Neon pink. Okay. I do have fuchsia down here. That's why I asked. So that's exciting. But the fuchsia is definitely more on the pink side of things. At least the one that we have here. There we go. Let's trim that. Okay, here goes nothing. That's so pretty. It's pretty for whoever wins it. Let me see. Can we go a little more? Yes, I want to. Because the arm, I don't know if you can see it. See this arm? It's not touching the cake. So I want to keep going until the arm touches the cake. But do I have anything as loud as that pink? And I've already used the yellow. So let's go back to the orange. Yeah, let's do that. I love that. Yeah, for sure. Hold on 1 second. I don't want to lose my place here. Okay. It's probably going to unwind. It's always good to, like I said, it's always good to keep tension on your yarn when you're winding. The minute you lose your tension, there's a slick chance that, you know, it'll slide off and things. So just be wary of that. There we go. Okay, just like. Let's try that again, Juan. Cheese and crackers. All right, there we go. Let's try that again. Okay. Let's do that. Nice and tight. And then over here, nice and tight. Are you kidding me right now? Is this really happening? I've just been tying these knots all video long, and all of a sudden, it's an issue. Let's see. Let's tie the knot, okay? And then let's tie this knot. Do 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 do. Okay, there we go. We did it. Guys, this is probably boring you to tears, and I do apologize, but it's fun. Look at how pretty that cake looks. Someone's gonna win this. It's so pretty, look at that. Are we touching? Are we touching? No, we're not touching yet. But I think that's good enough though. I don't know. Do we want to do another color? I don't know. I don't know. What can we throw on there that makes this, that will make this cake look amazing? No. Yes. We love a good black. Okay, this is definitely the color we needed. Okay, so, yes, my friends, we're gonna throw black onto this cake, and it'll almost be like, it'll look like the inside of a sushi roll. You know, except, you know, with the dark on the outside and all the bright, vibrant colors on the inside. Yeah, it'll be like a sushi roll. You know what? Oof. What the heck is even happening here? Okay. I don't know. Look. It's doing, like, I don't know. Sometimes it does what I need it to do, and sometimes it doesn't. I don't know. Because I'm not doing anything different here with the process, you know? Just tying on one end, and then tying on the other. Just like that. You see what I mean? Okay, maybe I just needed to talk it out. Talk it out, Juan. Just talk it out. You're fine. Okay, so we're gonna put a cap on this. There we go. You know what I might do? I might put black around all the scrap cakes. Oh yeah, like, you know, as an edge. Oh yeah, I love that. Love that idea. You guys like that idea? Oh yeah. This is so good. I love that idea. Okay. So cake one is finished. So this is going to be one of the cakes that I give away tonight on the live. I hope whoever receives this enjoys this. And they can actually say, hey, I saw my cake being made on Juan's channel. So that's fun. And I'm going to hold on to this black and use it for the edge. Oh, so classy. I love it. Okay. So that's what the cake is looking like. Love that. So I'm going to pop this off like so, like that. And then pull this off and then give it a good, oh, it's nice and solid too. And then with these, I'm just going to stuff them in the middle there. Okay, and then here we have the slip knot, which is nice too. Get in there, Juan, get in there. Okay, so there we go. Beautiful scrap cake. It's so pretty. I might actually. Yeah. Yep. Love that. That's so good. All those color changes. Look at all that. It's so good. Okay, friends. I mean, seriously. This is all the things. Yep. These scrap cakes. I need. Well, I'm doing two giveaways, and each giveaway is two cakes. So, yeah. Hopefully, this will inspire someone to, make some cakes of their own. They'll start a project with these two cakes and just be like, okay, let me make more of the ones that Juan made. So, at least that's what I'm hoping for. All right, let's move some of the neons out of the way. I love using neons with scrap cakes because it really, really makes it pop. Now, the corner to corner that I'm working on, I really didn't use many neon colors. But that's because I didn't realize how good it would look, But now that I know, I plan on using it. Oh, for sure. You bet your bottom dollar. I'm going to be throwing all sorts of neons in these scrap cakes. There's that. Let's throw some blue into this one. We love a good blue. All right. So I just have to figure out how to get faster at tying these magic knots. I wonder if there's a trick or a tip that would shortcut this situation to make it faster than I'm doing it. Because if I can do this and it be a time saver, I mean, I'll do this until the cows come home. You know what I mean? So, I think the more I do it, the better. I mean, the better accustomed to it I'll be. Again, very random, not really, keeping to account the amount of spins. I'm just counting for the sake of counting for myself, but no rhyme, no reason, friends. So I'm just going to do that with the one end, and then down here with this end, just go ahead and tie it like so, like that. What do you know? Okay. Time for some speckle. Red Heart Super Saver speckle. I mean, it's so unexpected to throw speckle right after this bright yellow. It's so good. Just for that reason, you know? But yeah, so I'm trying to think what would be the best project for scrap cakes. I mean, is there one project in particular that, makes sense when you're doing these? I mean, I think it's just so universal. It's just so universal that, I think you can literally work up anything with scrap cakes. It may not be the best looking type of thing that you're making, but isn't the beauty in the fact that it's so random? At least for me, it is. I think the more random it is, the more awesome it is. So. That's what I'm hoping for us. Very random, some thick, some thin. There we go. I'll just trim this red. It's insanely long. Okay. So. There we go. Okay. Let's pull out some of this. I haven't seen that in a minute. Okay, okay. Here we go. And you know what? I didn't realize how time consuming this can be until I timed myself one time. I'm like, Juan, why is this taking you so long? Well, it's an involved process, first of all. Like, you know, here I am answering my own questions. But yeah, it's a time-involved process. You know, I'm not really thinking about, you know, color sequence or anything. I'm trying to be as random as possible. Again, the only thing that's time-consuming are the knots. You know, I think that's one of the reasons why I resorted to do it, to do just like that simple knot. You know, again, there's no proper way, you know, to knot these things up. It's literally whatever you want to use. You know, whatever's best for you is fine. You know, and that's the beauty of having a scrap cake situation, because, you know, I know people who make scrap cakes and they use the Russian join. And, you know, they actually take that time to blend that yarn together in such a way that it looks continuous. But, you know, I look at this and I'm like, okay, friends, it's scrap cakes, okay? Just let it be that. Enjoy the scrap cakes for what it is. It is a scrap cake. It's called that for a reason. Enjoy it for what it is. Let's see, what other color can I throw in this? Oh yes, I need to use this up. So this is Big Twist Blue Speckle. So, yep, very unexpected. Okay, I keep forgetting my table is a lot higher today. I have a new table here. So, it's almost like I'm raising my arms all the way in the air to make a knot. There we go. Okay, perfect. Love this. Where did it go? Okay, good enough. Love that. Okay, what else? Let's hop back to another color. All right, so we're going to use the peach next. All right. I think for this video, friends, I'm only going to do like two scrap cakes just because of how time consuming it is. Depending, we'll see. I'm going to try and keep this to under an hour. We shall see. Okay. There's that. Let me trim this. Yeah, we need to trim this. Whoopsie. Okay, we went all over the place here. There we go. Let's go to something a little darker. Let's use blue. Yeah, we need some dark colors in here for contrast. So let's go ahead and do that. You know what's funny? You know, we really don't know what we have until we dig and find it. I know that's so common to say, but like, I didn't realize how many of these random colors of balls of yarn I actually had until I actually, you know, decided to organize and all that. I'm like, wow, Juan, look at all the things you can do now with all these colors. It's so awesome. Oops, let me trim that. So there's that. I think, you know, with me taking the extra time to do these knots this way, it's going to make it more fun for the person using it. To not have to worry about the aesthetics of like this ridiculous knot. Now you will have to trim, you know, a little more, but the knot itself, you will never have to worry about it coming apart. So there's that. Now I'm gonna put yellow back in there. I love the way that pops. Actually, yeah, I'm gonna put a little bit of yellow in this. Go to like a muted color, maybe like a mint green. We're missing some variegated. We need variegated in that. So maybe not mint green just yet. Maybe we can do some unicorn magic. That's the name of that colorway, by the way, I think. I showed her. Actually, no, it's not. It's not called Unicorn Magic because Unicorn Magic comes to us from Joann's. It's Joann's variegated yarn. The yarns I'm looking at are from Michael's Loops and Thread. Let me see. Do I have any Unicorn Magic in here? Calling Unicorn Magic. Is this it? Look at this. That's not Unicorn Magic. That is Hobby Lobby's yarn. And this is Ice Yarn. We're not putting this on here because this here is just a different feel altogether. Similar to Peaches and Cream. I don't have any Unicorn Magic, but I do have this. I have this and this, and then I have this. It looks similar, but it's kind of different, maybe different lots. What other variegateds do I have in here? Ooh, I have this one, Karen Jumbo. I may do that one. Yep, I may. I don't know yet. Yeah, that's enough. Cause I'm gonna sushi roll it with the black on the outside. I think that's so classy. I love it. Classy scrap cakes, my friends. Oh, classy scrap cakes. The irony. But yeah. If you win one of these cakes that I'm making here, can you guys please take a picture of your project and send it to me? I'm so curious to know what becomes of these cakes. I mean, you may actually not use them at all, probably. You guys, some of you may say, well, I won that at the giveaway, and so I don't want to use my cake. I want to hold on to it. What is even happening? I think I messed this up again. Darn it. Try it again. Okay, Juan, let's do it. There's that one. I mean, the process is so simple. I don't understand why it's not working. It's not working for me today. Okay, Juan. The simplest things sometimes turn out to be so trivial for me, and I'll never know why. But you give me something so complex and, you know, all the things, I get it right away. I don't know why. Okay. We may as well just finish this. Yeah, there's the end of the cake. And I think I'm gonna go with this for contrast. Yep, I'm gonna go with this for contrast. These are gonna go back. I'm gonna do some of this. Actually, no. I just said what I was gonna do and it wasn't that, it's this. Okay. So I don't know if I mentioned this, but all of the yarns are medium four weight yarns and they're all acrylic. So if you have any allergies towards the acrylic for whatever reason, just know that I'm telling you this now and I'm going to say it again during the live. Just so you guys are all in the know. There. How nice was that? That just flowed right together. Love that. Like two magnets. Okay. Seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Now, just, I don't know. I'm going to throw a little bit of yellow in here. Yeah, I need to throw something bright in there before I put the black on, you know? Just to make it so like vibrant and appealing to the eye. At least that's what I'm thinking in my head. There we go. So bring this down, pull this up. There we go. Perfect. Love that. Like it when it goes so smooth. Six, seven, eight, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Yeah, I think that's it for that. And then now I have to put the black on. You know, the finishing touch of our little sushi roll. Our little yarn sushi. Okay, there we go. Let's come down here and do all the things. There we go. Love this for us. Beautiful. Okay. I think I figured out the little trick. I should have rehearsed, but that's okay. We have black going everywhere. Oof. All right. We're almost there, friends. Almost. Yeah, that looks about right. So let's go ahead and trim that. So one lucky winner is going to get both of these cakes. And I'm so excited for them. And I'm just going to show you how I'm bagging it up, you know, for presentation's sake. So I'm going to take this off like that. That's the slip knot. And then I'm going to pull it up like this. Squeeze and squeeze. I love the way this looks. It's so good. So look at that. Isn't that amazing? It's so good. Okay. Now they're not going to be perfect in size. I mean, we're eyeballing it. So, I mean, that's just what that's going to have to be. Now, crinkle alert. I'm going to get the bags out of here. Do I have any out and available? No. Okay. So let me just pop this open. I'm going to bag it and show you. Let me just make sure that it's appealing to the eye. Okay, good. Okay, so I'll be using this. It's see-through. I won't have to take it out and touch it during the live. And so, what I'm gonna do is put them in there like that, provided that it closes. Let me see. Can I fit them in there side by side? No. Maybe I'll do them separate. Yeah, I want to do them separate. Yeah. That's perfect. Now, let me see. Do I have tape in this room? No, of course I do not. Okay, that's fine. Anyway, let's bag up this one very quickly. Guys, I hope you like this whole taking up situation. I mean, I don't really get an opportunity to say much while I'm doing these kinds of scrap cakes, but nonetheless, I hope I was good company. You got to hang out with me for a little while I prepare for tonight's live. These are the things that I do on Sundays to prepare. Sometimes I prepare ahead of time, but today was a busy day this morning, so there we have it. Those are the scrap cakes that are going up for the win tonight. I'm just not sure if we're going to do replay giveaways. Yeah, I may do the full gambit. I may actually do like a couple replay giveaways. I really like doing those short little videos. They're nice. And then I'll do a few giveaways during the live. I don't really want to take away from, like, you know, the whole giving thing, because I really enjoy giving things away. So, all right, friends, I hope you enjoyed this. I sure did. I had lots of fun, and I'm going to continue doing this. But for now, I'm going to cut this short. If you enjoyed this, hit the like button, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and hit that notification bell to stay updated with everything regarding me and my channel, my friends. So until the next one, that is it for now. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.